Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be exploring Google Cloud's Data Fusion service, a low-code platform for building robust and scalable data integration pipelines. We'll cover key concepts and walk through a practical, hands-on example to demonstrate its capabilities. Data Fusion simplifies the process of creating production-grade ETL extract, transform, load pipelines, making it an ideal tool for managing and scaling data workflows. It offers a wide range of connectors for various data sources and destinations, but today we'll focus on a simple use case, extracting structured data from cloud storage, transforming it, and loading it into BigQuery. Before we begin, let's head over to the Data Fusion page in the Google Cloud Console and enable the API. While that's in progress, let's take a moment to understand Data Fusion's pricing model. It follows an hourly rate with a free tier available for the basic edition. Beyond the free usage of 120 hours per month, the cost is approximately $1.80 per hour. With the API enabled, we can now create our Data Fusion instance. Select a region, choose the latest version, and opt for the basic edition to leverage the free tier. You'll notice additional accelerators available, such as continuous replication and advanced AI capabilities. Remember to grant the necessary access to the Compute Engine service account. To ensure proper governance, it's recommended to enable the Dataplex data lineage integration for efficient metadata cataloging. Once the instance is up and running, we'll dive into the Data Fusion interface. This platform not only allows you to execute ETL pipelines, but also provides features for metadata management, data lineage tracking, and data workflow orchestration. Let's navigate to the Hub section, where we can select from a variety of pipeline templates. For our example, we'll choose the Quick Start template. You can easily locate your pipeline in the Drafts section. One of the standout features of Data Fusion is its visual pipeline builder. It's like constructing a model piece by piece. We start with a cloud storage node, add parsing and transformation steps, and finally connect it to a BigQuery destination. Each operation's properties, schematics, and documentation are readily available for reference. The Studio interface offers a menu on the left, displaying various sources, transformations, and actions. If you can't find what you need, head over to the Plugin section in the Hub for additional options, including connectors for Elastic, MongoDB, and more. These plugins can be easily deployed, and you can even perform custom Python transformations if required. Now let's witness the magic of our pipeline in action. We can set triggers, schedules, and configurations. But for today, we'll simply run the pipeline directly by clicking the Run button. It's important to note that Data Fusion leverages Google Cloud's Dataproc service for the actual pipeline execution. If we navigate to the Dataproc page, we'll see a cluster being utilized to run our pipeline. The Data Fusion version is displayed, and it's worth mentioning that this is automatically managed by the platform. Dataproc itself is a powerful standalone service that can be used for data pipelines without the graphical user interface provided by Data Fusion. On the Dataproc page, you can observe the provisioning and auto-scaling of the compute resources backing the pipeline. The pipeline execution will commence once the compute resources are fully provisioned. As the compute cluster becomes ready, it will start running the job associated with our pipeline. Specifically, it is executing a Hadoop job. The labels on the Dataproc page provide detailed information about our Data Fusion pipeline. After a brief waiting period, we should see a succeeded status for our pipeline. The configuration details reveal the dataset and table that have been set up for the BigQuery sync. We can verify this in the BigQuery console. Additionally, if we refresh the Dataproc page, our job should now display a succeeded status and the cluster will be deprovisioned. This demonstrates the concept of ephemeral computing, where you only pay for the compute resources when they are actively in use. Let's take a look at the end result of our pipeline by examining the data that was extracted from cloud storage and loaded into BigQuery. We'll find our Quick Start dataset, which appears to contain a list of top-rated books based on the processed data. Querying the data reveals 22 results, including rankings and pricing information for each book. It's important to keep in mind that this example merely scratches the surface of what Data Fusion is capable of. The platform offers a wide range of possibilities for building complex data integration workflows, connecting to various data sources and destinations, and leveraging advanced transformations and data processing capabilities. If you have any questions or would like to learn more, please feel free to leave a comment below and we'll do our best to address them. Thank you for watching and please enjoy responsibly.